in the jungle, I can fly through the trees, way up high. I'm a one, I'm a two, I'm a toucan, so are you. A two, 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 toucan. Two, 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 toucan.
Yeah, good morning, everybody. Good morning. Wow. Good morning, Twinkle.
Morning, Miss Dave.
Twinkle, is everything okay? You sound like you're, well, a little stressed out.
Stressed out? What's that? I have never heard of being stressed out. And right now, I have too much to do to be stressed out. I have to clean my room. I've got to dust the cage, vacuum up all the feathers, wash the dishes, organize my Fruit Loops in the bathroom, and oh my goodness, and the furniture.
Wow. Boys and girls, does it sound like Twinkle has a lot of things that she needs to do?
Yeah.
Wow. Twinkle, why are you trying to do so much today?
Well, because tomorrow's the first day of spring. So today is spring cleaning day here at the Kidtricity Zoo.
Oh, well, Twinkle, it sounds like you have a lot of stress.
Stress? Stressed out? What is that?
Well, boys and girls, do any of you know what stress is? Do you know that word stress? What? Yeah. Can somebody tell me, what is stress? Let's see, does somebody have a good definition? Parent, what's stress?
It's when you have a lot of stuff to do and you're really frustrated.
Yeah, that's a great example. Good job, buddy. When you have a lot of stuff to do and you're feeling kind of frustrated, yeah. And we say you're stressed out. How many of you ever heard that before? All right, maybe you've heard someone say that. I'm feeling stressed out. All right, maybe they even say, oh, you're making me feel stressed out. I'm sure your parents never said that. But what does that mean if you're stressed out? Jonathan, what does that mean?
Excuse me, Dave. I'm
recording. Okay, you're really tired. You're overwhelmed. Yeah. Have any of you ever felt stressed out before? Yeah, me too. Quite often. Well, does it sound like Twinkle might be a little stressed out today?
Oh, I'm not just a little stressed out. I'm very stressed out. I have too much to do. I'm one stressed toucan.
Well, Twinkle, today we're going to be talking about what we can do when we feel stressed out. I think it'll help you, Twinkle.
Oh, that would be great, Pastor Dave. Until then, I have a lot of cleaning to do. Before I get back to it, can we sing a song?
Sure. Which song should we sing?
How about my favorite, Deep and Wide? But today, let's change the words to things that can stress us out.
Okay, we can do that. Change the words to things that stress us out. Okay, sure, Twinkle. We'll do that.
Cool. Well, back to my spring cleaning and my stress. Bye.
Can we say bye to Twinkle?
Bye, Twinkle.
All right. Well, Twinkle asked if we could sing some Deep and Wide. It's been a few weeks, so we'll humor the toucan. All right. Guys, show me some deep. Ready? Here we go. Deep and wide, deep and wide, there's a fountain flowing deep and wide. Deep and wide, deep and wide, there's a fountain flowing deep and wide. Now Twinkle said today we're going to change the words to what? Things that stress us out. So that could be anything, and that could be different things for different people. Something that stresses you out. Let's see, how about... Joshua, what stresses you out? Cleaning your room. All right, so instead of saying deep, we're going to sing cleaning your room. Ready? Cleaning your room and wide. Cleaning your room and wide. There's a fountain flowing. Cleaning your room and wide. Cleaning your room and wide. Cleaning your room and wide. There's a fountain flowing. Cleaning your room and wide. All right, I have to say it kind of fast. All right. Something else that stresses you out. Nora, what stresses you out?
Having to wake up.
Oh, yeah. That's stressful. All right, so we're going to say clean your room and wake up. Got it? Here we go. Say it fast. Clean your room and wake up. Clean your room and wake up. There's a fountain flowing. Clean your room, wake up. Clean your room and wake up. Clean your room and wake up. There's a fountain flowing. Clean your room and wake up. All right, something else that stresses you out. Let's see. Ava, what stresses you out?
Having to wash the dishes.
Having to wash the dishes. All right. Very good. Okay, so we're going to wash the dishes. Ready? Clean your room and wake up. Clean your room and wake up. There's a washing the dishes. Clean your room and wake up. Clean your room and wake up. Clean your room and wake up. There's washing the dishes. Clean your room and wake up. All right. I think we're almost to the point of we can't get any more words in there, but hey, let's do one more. Let's see. I'm going to go to this side. Let's see, how about, what stresses you out? What gives you stress? Sleeping. All right, hey, we all have our different stressors. All right, ready? Clean your room, wake up. Clean your room and wake up. There's washing the dishes. Sleeping, clean your room and wake up. Clean your room and wake up. Clean your room and wake up. There's washing the dishes. Sleeping, clean your room and wake up. You guys put me to the test today. All right. That was pretty good. Now, do you think there's even more things that stress people out than just those? Yeah. I bet we could put a really long list together. But before we do that, I know there's a little gorilla that really wants to come out and say hello. So is it okay if we get Go-Go out now?
Yeah!
All right, you guys ready to say good morning, Go-Go? Ready? One, two, three.
Good morning, Go-Go.
Let's see if he's in here. Go-Go, are you in here? Ooh, 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 ooh. Oh, I think I am. Ooh, 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 ooh. Okay, come on, Go-Go. Come on out. Go-Go, come on out. All right, that's wonderful. Boys and girls, sing. Go-Go, what are you doing? Go-Go, stop, Go-Go, boys and girls, what is Go-Go doing?
Dusting.
He's cleaning, he's dusting, that's a feather duster. All right, okay, Go-Go, stop, okay, good, all right, good. All right! Go-Go! Give me, all right, come on. Wow, Go-Go, you're busy cleaning today, huh?
Go-Go, do dusting.
Yeah, we see that. Go-Go, you're doing a lot of dusting. Oh, wait a minute. What did Twinkle say today at the Kentricity Zoo is what? The spring cleaning day. Are you helping with spring cleaning?
Go-Go, help. Go-Go, dust. Very dusty.
Yeah, I can see that. No, not now. Okay, we'll talk and then you can dust. All right. Go-Go, it seems like you have a lot of dusting to do.
Go-Go must clean. Go-Go feeling stressed out.
Oh. Go-Go's feeling what?
Stressed
out. Just like we were talking about. Oh, well, Go-Go, what do you do when you feel stressed out? How do you handle it?
Oh, Go-Go, dust.
Oh, what? No. Dusting when you're stressed out. Okay, Go-Go. All right. Okay, watch your... Okay, Go-Go. All right. Boys and girls, how does Go-Go handle it when he's feeling stressed? What does he do?
He
likes to dust. Oh, no. Be quiet. All right, be still. Got it? All right, well, it does sound like Go-Go's feeling what?
Stressed out.
And when Go-Go is stressed out, what does Go-Go like to do? Go-Go likes to... Hey! Okay, all right. Well, boys and girls, I see that Go-Go is very busy there. So I think let's say bye to Go-Go.
Bye,
Go-Go.
Bye, friends.
All right. Okay. Hey, watch where you're putting that. All right. Wow. Well, that is one way to handle stress. That when Go-Go's stressed, Go-Go likes to
dust.
Well, I bet when you guys feel stressed, you might have some other ideas that are maybe a little different than dusting. All right, so right now I want you guys to get in your groups and I want you to talk about those questions up on the screen. Let's see if I can remember. I heard washing the dishes, I heard waking up, cleaning up your room, and I heard sleeping. All right, those are all things. Are there any other things that stress people out in here? Let's see, what stresses you out? When you have multiple tests. Yeah, how many of you have to take tests sometimes? Yeah, that can be kind of stressful. All right, something else that stresses you out. Let's see, Stephanie, what's something that stresses you out? Okay, siblings. Yeah, our brothers and sisters. How many of you have brothers and sisters? Do you ever feel stressed with your brothers and sisters? No, that's good. If you say no, that's really good. All right. Well, I have two younger brothers, and a lot of times we had stress just trying to get along, especially when we were in the car on a long trip. All right. Well, how about this? What helps you to deal with stress? We learned that Gogo likes to deal with stress by doing what?
Dusting.
What helps you guys, though, when you feel stress? How about Ryan Spilker?
Playing video games.
Playing some video games. Just kind of relaxing. How about you, Ryan Prater?
Jumping on a trampoline.
Oh, that's a good one. Yeah. Let's see. Katie, how about you?
Playing with Sophie.
Playing with Sophie. Playing with your sister. Bristol, how about you?
Playing with friends.
Playing with friends. Caitlin?
Seeing friends.
Seeing friends. Emma?
Taking a big breath.
Oh, taking a big breath. Oh, good one. Brock, how about you?
When I get stressed out. When I play basketball a lot.
Okay, play basketball a lot. All right.
I'm a little one.
Exercise. That's a good one. Charlotte, how about you?
When I hear things knocking on the door, I get stressed out.
Oh, you get stressed when you hear somebody knocking on the door. Yeah, you know what? Me too. So I put those signs, no soliciting. Yeah, all right. Let's see. Ava, how about you? Okay, you get to see your cousins. That's a good way to fit. Kira, how about you? Okay, very good. Yeah, you guys, those are awesome ways. Nora, how about you?
Think about what you're thankful for.
Think about what you're thankful for. Wow. You guys, that's a great way to deal with stress. You know what? I like your ideas a lot better than dusting. Yeah. Now, here's the last question. Can God help us with stress? What do you guys think? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah, that's a big yes. But how can God help us with stress? How can God do that? Jackson, how does God help us with stress?
You know that he's there for you.
You know that he's there for you. Yeah, exactly. How else can God help us with stress? Yeah. Okay, yeah, he can help with the little things. That's right. How about you, Caleb?
We can read the Bible.
We can read the Bible. And you know what? I heard Michelle over here talking about some Bible stories. And do you think people in the Bible ever had stress? Yeah. They had all kinds of stress. And was God with them when they were stressed? Yeah, and we can read about how God helped them. Would that help us feel better? Yeah, absolutely. Bristol, how else?
He can help us learn that stress is kind of good for you.
Okay, he can help us learn that there are good stresses. Yeah, exactly. Wow, you guys got this one down. Well, I think you've done a wonderful job with this, and I think you guys know a lot more about stress than Gogo Gorilla and Twinkle the Toucan, all right? But before we feel too good about Kitricity, it's that time again to bring out a certain platypus. So on the count of three, we're going to say good morning, Platy. Ready? One, two, three.
Good morning, Platy.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning, Pastor Dave. Good morning, Miss Sarah Brockford.
Good morning, Platy. Platy, could you please share with us what's up for today?
Pastor Dave, I heard you are talking about different ways to deal with stress.
Oh, boys and girls, is that right? Are we talking about different ways to deal with stress today? Yes, yes, we're talking about that today.
Well, thankfully, I, the platypus, Platy, I'm here to help everyone deal with their stress.
Oh, really? Did you guys hear that? Platy wants to help us deal with our stress. Platy, I find that to be rather surprising, since you cause me more stress than anyone else I know.
This is about you, Pastor Dave. It's about reducing stress. I have asked some of my animal friends here at Kidtricity to share how they deal with stress. For example, you saw that Gogo likes to dust.
Oh, boys and girls, did we see that? Gogo likes to dust. Yes, we saw that. Yeah, well, we did.
Well, Awesome Possum has an idea on how to deal with stress, too. Awesome? Come out and show us how you deal with your stress.
Awesome Possum.
Hey, Platy Man. Hey, Pastor Dan Man.
Hey, Awesome.
The way I deal with stress is the same way I deal with any problem. I play possum, man, like this.
You play possum, so you pretend that you're dead.
Yeah, man.
How does that work out for you?
Not too well, man. Sometimes people freak out and call an ambulance for me.
Yeah, that isn't good. That wouldn't be good. Boys and girls, do you think that playing possum, pretending that you're dead, is a good way to deal with stress?
No.
That's okay, Pastor Dave. Some of the other animals have some ideas, too. Preco! Hey, come out here!
Well, when I'm stressed, this is what I like to do. I like to do this. Oh!
What? Twinkle, what are you doing? Twinkle, what are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing? I'm dealing with the stress.
Where's it goes? Do you see that?
Ow!
So, Twinkle, when you're stressed, you smack your head on something?
That's right. Ow! Oh my goodness, I got a headache.
Twinkle, how does that work out for you?
It hurts.
Yeah,
Maybe not the best method, but don't worry, we have more.
All good.
Hey, Bernie, come on out!
Hello, friends! How are you?
Okay, Bernie.
Bernie, how do you handle that stress?
Well, when I feel stressed out, I like chewing on things. It helps me calm down. What can I chew on? Come here, Awesome.
What? No.
Hey, Bernie. Not cool, man. Watch those teeth, man.
Sorry, I couldn't find anything else. I'm feeling stressed.
And how does chewing on things work out for you, Bernie?
For me, it's not too bad. Other people don't like it very much.
Yeah, man, I don't like it at all.
Platy, I don't think any of these are really good ideas on how to handle stress.
Well, that's okay, because I'm going to share the best idea for last.
The best idea for last on how to handle stress? What idea is that?
My idea?
Oh, no.
When I'm stressed, I deal with it by singing and dancing. Play the music! I deal with some stress, everybody!
No, that's not necessary. That's not necessary. All right. They're going to deal with stress. All right, okay. All right, okay. Well, it looks like Platy deals with stress by singing and dancing. And what's Awesome doing to deal with stress? Playing dead. And Bernie, he's chewing, yes. All right. And what's Twinkle doing?
Whacking
her head. Yeah. Boys and girls, I just want to say right now, please don't try any of these methods at home. Now, don't try them at your friend's home. And please don't try it if you're a kid, Tristan, either. Bernie. All right. You guys, you can stop now. All right. Awesome. There. All right. Bernie, let go of Awesome. Bernie, that's Awesome's tail. All right. Okay. Twinkle, no. It's not going to end well. Twinkle. Bernie, release. All right. Bernie, it's okay. It's all right, Bernie. It's okay. All right. Awesome. Okay. There it is. Okay. Twinkle. All right. Okay.
Sometimes I think my way of dealing with stress seems to create a lot of stress for you, Pastor Dave.
Yes, it sure does. Anyway, Braddy, could you now please share with us what's up for today?
Sure thing. This week's What's Up is some very good advice on how to handle stress. Take a look at the screen for this week's What's Up!
Oh, let's look over there. It says, I will come to God's presence when I feel stressed out. Now, buddy, that is the best advice I have heard on how to deal with stress.
I know. I'm one wise platypus. Now, remember, when I say, what's up, you need to stand up and say what's up for today.
Okay, we got it. Thank you, Platy. Thank you very much. I will come to God's presence when I feel stressed out.
Good job. You can sit down, but watch for me later. Bye!
Bye, Platy. All right. Well, boys and girls, it is time for the Bible story. So who do we need to bring out to introduce our Bible story?
Bernie
the Bear. Come on out, Bernie.
Hello, Pastor Dave. Hello, friends.
Hello, Bernie.
With all this talk about stress, I have another question for you, Pastor Dave.
Okay. What's your question, Bernie?
What's black and white? Black and white? Black and white.
What's black and white? Black and white? Black and white. Bernie, I don't know.
A stressed out panda rolling downhill. I'm killing it, Bernie in the house.
Wow. Yet another bear joke.
No, not just a bear joke. It's a panda joke.
Oh, right. Wow. Okay.
There's only one Bernie the Bear, baby. Well, let's get on to the Bible story. Let me grab your Bible, Pastor Dave. Hang on.
Okay. All right. These bear jokes. Wow. Amazing.
You love them.
Thank you, Bernie. Bernie, where's our Bible story from today?
Today's Bible story comes from the book of Luke. Boys and girls, do you know which part of the Bible Luke is in? Is it the Old Testament or the New Testament?
Show me one for Old Testament, two for New Testament for the book of Luke.
Those fingers.
Old or new?
If you have two up, you're correct. Luke is in the New Testament.
That's right.
Pastor Dave, I hope you all enjoyed today's Bible story. And I'll be back next week with another fantastic bear joke.
I know.
Bye, friends.
All right. Can we say bye to Bernie? Bye, Bernie. One of these days, the internet's going to run out of bear jokes. Okay. Well, boys and girls, Bernie said, where does our Bible story come from today? The book of Luke, which is in the New Testament. Very, very good. Well, today's story is about a time when a friend of Jesus was feeling really stressed out. So let's start our story. There were two sisters that were good friends of Jesus. The first sister was named Martha. Martha, could you please come out? Oh, Seth is going to be our Martha. All right, nothing strange there. All right, very good. This is Martha with a beard. All right. Martha's sister was named Mary. Would Mary please come out? All right. Now, Mary? Larry is Mary. All right. Okay. All right. More phone calls for me this week. Okay. All right. Wonderful. So we've got, help me remember, we've got Martha and Mary. All right. Very good. Now, one day, Martha and Mary had a very special visitor come to their home. Who do you think the special visitor was?
Jesus.
Jesus, that's right. Very good. The special visitor was Jesus. Can we have our Jesus actor out here, please? Oh, okay, Miss Laura's going to be our Jesus actor. Wonderful. Now, boys and girls, if Jesus came to your house, would it be a little deal or a big deal?
Big deal.
Yeah, big deal. That's right. And that's exactly what Martha thought. Martha wanted everything to be perfect for Jesus. So Martha looked around her house and realized it was way too messy to have Jesus there. So what do you think Martha did? She started cleaning. Can we get Martha's cleaning supplies out here, please? All right. Boys and girls, is it important to clean our house when we have a special visitor? Yeah. Is that a vacuum? All right. Well, that's not exactly the right time period, but that's okay. All right. Martha began to clean everything. She cleaned the furniture. She cleaned the walls. She cleaned the ceiling. She cleaned the floor. She dusted. She scrubbed. She vacuumed. She cleaned and cleaned and then cleaned some more. But boys and girls, there was still dust everywhere, so Martha kept cleaning. Then Martha realized that Jesus was probably hungry. So what do you think Martha did?
Cook.
She started cooking. That's right. Can we get Martha's cooking supplies out here, please? Alright. So Martha began to cook a huge meal for Jesus. She whisked. She mixed. She mashed. She cooked and cooked and cooked some more. And as Martha cooked, she noticed there was still more dust. So while she cooked, she cleaned. She cooked and cleaned. She cleaned and cooked. She cooked and cleaned. She cleaned and cooked. While Martha was cooking, cleaning, and stressing out, do you think that was a lot of stress to do all that? Yeah. She looked around for her sister Mary. Martha was hoping Mary would help her with all this work. But she couldn't find Mary. When she finally found Mary, guess where Mary was? Mary was in the other room, sitting at the feet of Jesus and listening to Jesus talk. While Martha was doing all this important cleaning and cooking, Mary had just been spending time with Jesus. Well, boys and girls, how do you think Martha felt?
Disappointed,
sad. I think she maybe even felt a little angry. Yeah, she sure did. She was doing all the work. She was feeling all the stress. And what was Mary doing? Just sitting there, listening to Jesus. Martha ran up to Jesus and complained, "Lord, isn't it unfair that Mary is here with you while I'm doing everything else?" Now, Jesus said something very interesting back to Martha. He basically said, "Martha, Martha, you have to understand something. You're worried and stressed out about so many things. But Mary has chosen what is really important, being with me." What was Jesus telling Martha? Jesus was telling Martha that when you are stressed out, when you're worried, what's the best way to handle our stress? To be with Jesus and God. That's right. Mary understood this. Instead of getting all upset like Martha, Mary went to be with Jesus. When we're feeling stressed out, who should we be like? Martha trying to do everything? Or should we be like Mary and spend time with Jesus? What do you guys think?
Mary.
That's right. We want to be like Mary. We may not want hair like Mary, but we want to be like Mary. That's right. Now, do you think that when we go to Jesus, he can help us with our stress?
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know what? The Bible doesn't tell us what Martha decided to do after talking to Jesus, but I hope she made the right decision. I hope that she stopped and saw how to handle her stress. I hope she joined Mary and sat with Jesus. After all, who knows? Maybe Martha stopped all her cooking and cleaning and just ordered a pizza instead. Can we get a pizza out here for Mary, Martha, and Jesus, please?
Pizza Hut.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you.
I got pizza.
Perfect. All right. Well, boys and girls, can we give our actors a big hand? Thank you very much. Okay, come here. Can I get up? You gotta get Miss Mary and Larry over there to put their screen on. All right, you guys ready? All right. I will come to God's presence when I feel stressed out.
Good job. See you next week. Bye.
All right, bye, Gladdy. All right, wonderful. Well, boys and girls, you have done an outstanding job today. But before we go, would it be okay if we brought Ginger the Fox out?
Yeah.
All right. She's got a power verse of the day, so give her your best smile and a wave, and let's find out, what does the fox say? Here comes Ginger looking for someone to give the verse to today.
Dog goes woo, cat goes meow.
Let's see who will Ginger choose today.
Cow goes moo, frog goes croak.
Brock, all right, come on up, Brock. Come on up, buddy. All right. Can we say bye to Ginger? Bye, Ginger. Miss Jessica, not a fan of What Does the Fox Say. All right. Well, Brock, should we see what the power verse is from the Bible? All right. Let's take a look. Let's see here, Brock. It says, come to me, all of you who are weary and carry heavy burdens. Heavy burdens means lots of stress. And Jesus says, I will give you rest. Matthew 11:28. Thank you, Brock. You can keep that. Wonderful. Well, boys and girls, can we all fold our hands, bow our heads, and we're going to pray to God. Dear God, help me when I feel stressed.
Help me to remember
to come into your presence,
to ask you for help,
and thank you that you are always with me. And all the children said, Amen. All right, you guys can line up, head to your classes, and we'll see you next week for another Kidtricity.